Marissa.
I'm Annie.
I'm Brandon.
I'm Eliana.
And today's word of wisdom is gossip.
Did you hear that Marissa brought a mouse in her pocket today?
Really?
Yes. Let's go tell Annie.
Did you hear that Marissa brought a mouse in her pocket?
No way.
Yes, literally.
Actually?
Yeah. Isn't that so weird?
Guys, no, I was just telling you.
How's it going?
Hi. Just some people are spreading a rumor about me that I brought a mouse in my pocket.
That is an interesting piece of information. Now I have to ask you, did you bring a mouse in your pocket to school?
No.
Okay, so not true. Any idea why they would say this about you?
No, not really.
So no history of bringing mice in your pocket?
Yeah.
I'll be right back. So do you guys want to share with me any pieces of information you may have been saying about Miss Marissa?
Well, I told Bryn that Marissa brought a mouse in her pocket today.
Interesting choice. Okay, so I want you to think, guys. When we're saying information about each other, compliments, great. I always say, never keep a compliment in, always share it, right? But this was something, was it kind?
No.
So I want you guys to remember Wave Rider's think, and I've got it on the wall here. So I want you to think, first of all, was it true, did Marissa bring a mouse in her pocket?
No.
Was it helpful information?
Not at all.
No. Was it important?
Yes.
If she had brought in a mouse?
Yeah.
So I'm thinking that person knew it wasn't true and it wasn't helpful. Important if it was an unsafe thing. That's important too. If there ever is something that's unsafe, tell a grown-up immediately, okay? All right, what about necessary?
No.
Was it kind?
No.
No. So always remember, Wave Riders think, is it true? Is it helpful? Is it important? Is it necessary? Is it kind? If it is something that's unsafe, always tell a grown-up. Otherwise, moments when you hear something, just think, you know what? I'm going to think about this. This isn't something I'm going to keep spreading. A rumor's like spreading poison, and you spread poison to each other. And when it's not true, it's hurtful, right, at the end of the day. And we're all friends here, yeah?
Yeah.
All right, my friends, can you give my friend Marissa an apology, please?
We're sorry, Marissa.
I didn't mean to gossip about you.
I didn't mean to spread the rumor.
I didn't mean to be mean.
It's okay. Group hug?
Yeah! Group hug!
Awesome!
And that's why you should never gossip. Gossip is the wrong thing to do.
Really? Yes, sir!
Yeah!
Just watch. Don't believe.
in Mississippi. If we show up, we're gonna show up. Smoother than a fresh drop, skip it.
Too hot,
hot, yeah.
Call the police and a fireman. Too hot,
hot, yeah.
Make a dragon wanna retire, man. Too hot.
And guess what? We have a spirit day on September 27th. Guess what? You get to wear your pajamas. Don't forget.
That's what I like about you.
Hey, Wave Riders, here's what I like about you. I walk into all of these extra programs we have. We call them specials or enrichment programs. I love seeing you guys having fun and enjoying our STEAM lab, science every week, our art class, art every week, our PE time every week, our music class every week. These programs are paid for by donations from you guys, your families. We have 42% of our population has already donated, so we're funded through November. That's great. But what about December and January? That's the rest of the first semester. And I need all of you to talk to your parents and say, hey, have we donated yet? We have fun incentives. In fact, Miss Smith's class are gonna get redesigned this facial hair of mine and some other incentives. Silly string battle. Two students, three students, four students are gonna be able to put something into the time capsule. And 80% participation in your class, you get a popsicle party. We do that just kind of have some fun incentives. But more importantly, the incentive is we don't want those classes to disappear. We want to keep them funded all the way through the first semester. 372 of you haven't had your families donate. If each family donated $250, the recommended amount, we would pay for all the programs through the end of March. That'd be amazing. Even if the remaining 372 of you donated just $100 per family, we would fund the entire first semester. We don't want those programs to go away, but if we don't get the funds, then we can't have those programs. So it's easy. So ask your parents, hey, have we donated yet? And get your money in to support our programs because we love them and we love our community supporting each other because that is what I like about you.
That's what I like about you.
Pete,